spirit lies. And we give you thanks for the little time or the time that our brother Benson has spent with us on this earth. The time that he shared with us. Come together to give more thanks for even knowing him this afternoon, this morning. Notwithstanding the solemnity of this moment, we still ask each and every one to join their hands and hand together to give God thanks and praise as we are about to go through our divine goodness. Be in the life and in memory of our brother Sona, Ramchan, Vincent, who choose not to be with us in flesh any longer, but that journey to meet the one who had prayed to him out of the door. That being so, said brethren, we'll start our divine service by singing from on your leaflet. Who have the leaflet? What a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
All our sins and griefs to bear.
All our sins and griefs to bear.
What a privilege to carry.
What a privilege to carry.
Everything to God.
Everything to God in prayer.
What peace we often forfeit.
Oh, what peace we often forfeit.
Oh, what needless pain we bear.
Oh, what needless pain we bear.
Only because you do not carry.
Thank you.
night of agony.
Virgin, I will now read as a foundation a portion of scripture taken from the 15th chapter of the 1st Corinthians. From the 20th verse, I will read a portion, and then I read from the 25th to the 50th verse. For the believer. we were to be assured about his life, the man Christ Jesus. But now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. But every man in his own order. Christ, the first fruits, after they that are Christ at his coming. Then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power. For he must reign till he had put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. From the 35th verse I read, but some men will say, how are the dead raised up? And with what body do they come? Thou fool. That which thou sowest is not quickened, except it die. And that which thou sowest not that body that shall be, but bare grain, it shall make chance of wheat or of some other grain. But God giveth it a body as it hath pleased him, and to every seed his own body. All flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds. There are also celestial bodies, and bodies terrestrial, but the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. There is one glory of the sun, and another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars. For one star differed from another star in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption, and it is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown in natural body, it is raised in spiritual body. There is a natural body, and there is a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man Adam was made a living soul. The last man Adam was made a quickening spirit. Howbeit, that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural. Howbeit, and afterward that which is spiritual. The first man is of the earth, earthy. The second man is the Lord from heaven. As it is written, such are they also that are earthy, and as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the earthly, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Neither do a corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? And O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be not steadfast, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I rest at the 58th word of the scripture.
I heard a voice of Jesus.
Come unto me and rest.
Come unto me and rest.
I am in a resting place.
I come in a resting place.
He has made me glad.
And he has made me glad.
Glory to the Father.
Glory to the Father. And to the
showing us that man possesses something that he is interested in, and man must seek to save that which God is interested in that man. There is a deeper part of man that this foundation tell us. He say, since by man came death, right? Adam the first man sinned and died. He say, by man come also the resurrection of the dead. By the same man. And who is that man? The man Christ Jesus. For us to believe. He walked on the earth, he lived. He resurrected. Conquered death. He lived after death. And when his good friend Lazarus had died, and his sisters Mary and Martha were waiting, Christ came upon and he cried unto Christ, look, we put that dead. 4 days now, you know, he's thinking right now. Say, brother, he's not dead, he's asleep. But he couldn't understand what Christ was saying. Christ saying, he will rise, he will rise again. And they think it was judgment he was speaking about. Knowing that it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death coming the judgment. But Christ was giving Mary and Martha hope in telling them, I am the resurrection, I am the life. And if a man believeth in me, although he may die, he say, yet shall he live. You can't understand that. He said, and if a man liveth and believeth in me, he shall never die. He still cannot understand what Christ was saying. But his understanding of it was, you can kill the body, but you can't kill the soul. You can't kill the spirit. He was saying to us, what is flesh is flesh. What is spirit is spirit. He was saying that living soul, that he breathed the breath of life into man. So that man must save that soul. That is what a man must save. His soul alive, the living soul. And for us to save that, it will depend on the life we live. And what we do in our flesh, in our mortal body, in our mortal frame. We must acknowledge what we do in our mortal frame. So this evening, this morning, brethren, we stand on the word. It's our consolation. And for those who believe us, the songwriter say that he that believeth, this is he who have that everlasting life. He that believeth in the Father and the Son, he had an everlasting life. So for the assurance of the believers, those that believe it, on his name. He say, come into this world that none shall perish through sin. But who hear it, the testimony of Christ and believe it, will be saved from the wrath, from the great transgression. So, a little lower down in the same book of Corinthians, show us that what state the man must be in to enter into the kingdom of God. He said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. He said, if this corruptible flesh must put on incorruption, and this mortal body we have here, this mortal frame, must put on immortality. Yes? Must put on immortality. So when the corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and the mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying, is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Get a victory over this, over death. So he live again, we also shall live again. Say, O death, where is thy sting? And O grave, where is thy victory? Virgin, So as we are being reminded by death, death is only to remind us here who are alive, because the death, we have, the writer said, don't mourn over the happy dead, for no sickness, no pain, no bills, nothing terrible in the arms of the Father, him who has sent him. For us who are alive, we have the worry how we live. For him, death itself is past. For him, death itself is past. He passed everything. The whole journey he goes through is we here. Have to face what we have to face. And don't know when this will come for us. But we know that it is coming. This is to remind us that it's coming for every man. It's not to get you frightened. This is just to remind us that it has no age, no color, no creed, no class, no book, whatever this do could save you when this comes to you. All we have to do is live our best lives. As young people say, live your best life. Do the best you could while you could do it. Live good. Because when this comes upon you, you can't ask God for no mercy. You can't ask for no forgiveness. You got no forgiveness. You say the grave, there's no. You can't praise God in the grave. You can't answer nothing. At the same state, death meet you, you'll be judged in your state. And that will depend whether that soul that God breathed into man, breathed in his nostrils, and man became a living soul. In other words, it was seen that man was in this state, that man didn't have no life. And God breathed in man and made him a living soul. And it's that soul that God is interested in. That's why he sent his son to walk on earth and die for us. That whosoever believes and see his soul alive, and in death shall come upon him, yet shall he live. For this was virgin, as time is upon us, I pray that if he words of my mouth and meditation is flowing of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight. We have any reading of the eulogy, or we don't have it. You have it? Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Who would like to read the eulogy? We'll have the eulogy read. At this time, we try to get it back.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Right, came here today to pay our last respects to Swana. Alright, so I'm just here to read, you know, a few things I could put into words while writing this for him. Alright, there's more everyone have to put in, but if we have to go on, we'll write about 1,000 books about his life. Alright, so here's a brief of how Swana lived his life on earth. I stand here today to pay tribute to a kind soul, an indulgent heart, and a disciplined mind. Ramcharan Bhimsingh, also known as Swana or Bangi, was an angel whom we have all come to love and cherish for the years he has spent on this earth. Today we all gather to pay our last respects to this amazing, most dedicated and caring person who has touched our lives personally. All of us have known him in a variety of roles. He was the father of one, a husband, uncle, brother, son, and a great friend. I have been privileged to know him as a best friend and a brother. It is within this context I will speak and share of the great person which Swana was to each one of us. Before I embark on this journey, I want to ask you a question. When you hear the name Ramcharan Bhimsingh, what words immediately come to your mind? If you're like me, there's no single word to choose from. From the small length of time I came to know Swana, I would say there's no one in this world that can wear his shoes. Swana was the simplest person anyone could find. He made nothing an issue or problem. He lived his life to the fullest. He was full of joy and compassion and understanding. I knew him as jack of all trades and trade of none. I never came across someone that can be so willing and work so hard to achieve what he wants. His life could be all kind of chaos, but he never wore it on his face. He would steer his focus towards the lighter side of things. And I'm sure he taught some, if not all of us, how to do the same. He will always try to find solutions instead of making things a problem. Even when he was tired, he made sure and treated others as though they were precious too. His was a light that shined brightly, just so the path of others could illuminate. He was also a light that exemplified brilliance in every capacity. With matters that had to do with all things life, he was an exceptional juggler. Sona was the most adventurous person I came across. He could hunt, fish, plant, build things from scratch, and he was handy and willing to fix anything. For each one of us here, he did so many things for us. He taught many of us new things. For example, he taught me how to build windows, cut materials, and he gave me that extra push to learn to deal with life from a more positive angle. To find another person like Sona is impossible. He knew how to survive. He knew how to live. But today, he left behind an aching mother, trying to find solace in the arms of an equally aching father. He has also left behind his one and only son, who admired him so much and was going in his footsteps. He also left behind siblings who are crushed to the core, and a wife who don't even know where she should go from here, because she is so confused and crippled because he is no longer here to make her feel whole. And we shouldn't be mad at him. We are all just in pain. But hey, what's the sun without a little rain? You're not here, Sona, but your presence lingers in the shadows. You may not see what we see, but we can hear you laughing and smiling with us when we laugh. Lives are like rivers. Eventually they go where they must, not where we want them to. These words have kept me going thus far. At least we know each moment has unfolded like it should have. That there's nothing we could have done to be your savior, as much as we all wish we could have. And no matter what tomorrow brings, we will embrace tenacity, compassion, and selflessness, just the way you would have. For many years, he sought the beast, a hunting man who's now deceased. He roamed the forests and hills far now. Now he hunts upon a star. Many years before he passed, he lived a life of simple tasks. He did not need a fancy car or truck. He just needed two muscle legs, that's all. He had a love within his life. An angel woman was his wife. She guided him through hard and thin and raised his child just to be like him. As I stand here and speak, he was a dad, a son, a husband, and a soul to keep. Those days are gone and we all miss him so much. A hunting man with his dogs in tow. This man was loved by all who knew, his family, friends, and child too. I'm proud to say that Sona was part of my life, and it was a blessing to have him by our sides. He lived a short life here on earth, and I would say he lived it to the fullest. So as I come to the end, I would like to say, son, you would be missed by each and every one of us every day. But we all know you're in a better place now. Fly high, Sona, and may you find peace wherever you may go. I won't wish you goodbye. I'll just say until we meet again. Till then, enjoy your freedom. And one day, by God's grace, I hope to see you again. Thank you, everyone.
As you move quickly, we have everyone being open to what you hear from anyone about this family who would like to say anything more. Come fast, we have a limited time.
Good day, everyone.
Good day,
everyone. I am the wife of Sona. I want to tell you all that today, this man here is somebody that even anybody who enters his life for one day would see him as a gel, a golden gel, golden pearl. He touched everybody who didn't even know him. And I would like him to be remembered as somebody of dignity in everyone's heart here today. He has given me the strength to stand with him because he knew I would stand with him. And I have stand with him from the day he said, later babe. And I'm standing today. He never did say goodbye. And he will never say goodbye. And I will always remember that from him. Even though we cannot see him, but keep in mind, he's just the same person you all will have in all your head. Just know that he is somebody that will always be and always will in everybody's heart be loved with. And he will want to know how will his son go on and how I go on. But he have given me the strength to move from here today. And I will move today, because he always say, I am his leader. And I will lead him. And I will lead him and let him go. And I will make sure that his family is also led and be a leader also. So, there's no goodbye. There's only love for Swana. So nobody, please don't say goodbye to him. You can just tell him later until we meet again.
Would you let us all stand and sing this hymn on our leaflet in the street by and by? There's a land that is fairer than fair. By faith we can see it afar.
And by faith we can see it afar.
God awaits over the wave.
For the Father of me.
So prepare us a dwelling place there.
To prepare.
We ask Almighty God, the God of grace, who did send your Son, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to men, we most humbly and heartily give thee thanks that by this death he destroyed the power of death, and by his glorious resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to our believers. And because he lived, we also shall live, that neither death nor life, nor nothing present or nothing to come, no heights, no depths, shall be able to separate us from the love which is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. For those that know me, say, Father God, Almighty God, give up all mercies. Deal graciously, I pray, with all those that mourn, that they may know the consolation of thy love and help them to go through this period of loss of their loved one, resting in the hope of meeting him again in glory. As you have promised life to them that believe in your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I will sing him, Jesus, lover of my soul.
Jesus, lover.
Christian soul out of this world, in the name of God the Father, who created thee, in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Son, who redeemed thee, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, who sanctified thee. May your rest be this day in peace, and your dwellings in the paradise of God. Now sing Amazing Grace as we leave, about to get ready to leave for the burial ground.
Amazing Grace.
faith.
Yes, man.
Save us.
I took it in.
Keep them close. Cause the pressure just a thump like a mother right now. The week is a feeling.
Why are they doing this thing? who want to see, don't stand up to hear this song. Just take a pass on and just you pit here whatever, take whatever pit here, because when they're ready and they say go down, that means go down. So all you can do is who didn't get to see the pit here of them.
Before Gio has offered, nation bow with sacred joy, nation, sacred joy, with sacred, know that the Lord is God alone, know that, that is God alone, is God. Formed us men, formed us men, and formed when like one can sheep we stray, and like can sheep we stray, in sheep we brought us to his fold again, thankful songs we come back. Thankful songs we thank. As I have a voice is raised, I have a voice is raised. A voice said, who took 10,000 tongues? And with 10,000 tongues, 10,000. Fill thy court with song, then we shall fill thy court. Shall fill thy court. Shall fill thy court. Fill thy court. Why not thou would in thy command? Why not thou thy command? Is thy pass as eternity thy long? Pass as it. From as a rock that truth must stand, from as a rock that truth must stand, that truth shall stand. When rolling air shall cease to move, when rolling years, when rolling years shall stand. Maketh me to lie down. Leadeth me beside the still waters. Restoreth my soul. Leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yet if I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head before my soul. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. But then, for as much as it pleased the Almighty God to accept the soul of our brother Ram Charan Brimson, here departed, I now commit his body to the cross. Earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, so on
Satan to receive resurrection unto. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, may the love of God, may the fellowship of His Holy Spirit, may it rest and abide with us all.
Amen. I'm going to show you now. You sing. Is that him?
I want to be there.
I'm very sunny, so just take a little break before the sun will grow up.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, Chris, take a shot, Lucas.
Let's go.
Oh, great.
I'm on a great hour.
And sing my
After 6 weeks, huh? Come back and mold it again. But you
raise the weight drop,
and it will
be better
than the gold. It's
not even better, man. It's better than beyond the man.
You try to conceive, and they got a raise drop. You go for
the man who drove so like he like he come like a fire burning here. You know, blazing fire burning here, you put me to rest, you can sleep. I will become another guy. Now this is like a Bible. I love the Bible. I'm happy to make a red tree. You know, give me a red red tongue. Hold on. Yo, you're blocking your camera, right? Hold on.
Yeah, good. Yeah.
No chicken? Yeah, boy, shit, boy,
sorry.
Sorry! You didn't come with us. You didn't come with us. Right over it, notice again. Oh, you see you today. I don't see tomorrow.
Thank you.